In this screencast, we are going to use the Bernoulli equation for an unsteady state flow system in which we're interested in modeling the change in water height in a conical tank with time. So we have water draining from a tank through a hole with radius r, so we'll call this distance little r, and the height of the water will be a function of time, so we'll call this h of t. So we want a relationship between the height and time. So let's start with some assumptions so that we could use a simplified Bernoulli equation for this. First, let's assume that the fluid is inviscid, that there are no viscous effects. We're also going to assume that the follow is a streamline out of the cone, and that the fluid is incompressible, which for water, that in this case, is probably a pretty good assumption. Now, we can't assume that it's steady state because it is changing with time, and you can imagine from experience that as that height changes and gets lower to the bottom, that velocity of the height of that liquid level moving downwards starts speeding up. So, using this information, we could write the following Bernoulli equation. I've labeled my point 1 as the bottom of the tank and my point 2 as the liquid level at the top. So, using this equation, we're going to assume that the tank is open to atmosphere, and as the water's coming out of the tank, the bottom is open to atmosphere. So, P1 is going to equal P2, which is going to equal 0. So, we'll use a gauge pressure. So we have Z1, in this case, equaling 0, and Z2 equaling h of t. So we need to write expressions for the velocities. So V2 is going to be the change in the liquid level height with time. And this is in the negative direction. That's how we're going to write our differential for the change in height. Now we are going to assume at first that this is going to be much, much less than the velocity at point 1. So doing this, we can model the velocity at point 1 as a free jet. So keep in mind, even though V2 is not equal to 0, we still solve the Bernoulli for a steady state case so that it gives us the free jet at point 1. Okay. Now this is where we bring in the continuity equation. With incompressible flow, that the mass flow rate in the downwards direction at point 2 must be the same mass flow rate at point 1, and we write this as such. So now we have an expression where the velocity at point 1 times the cross-sectional area at point 1 must equal the velocity of the fluid at point 2 times the cross-sectional area at point 2. Well, the cross-sectional area at point 1 isn't changing, but that at 2 it is. So we need a relationship of the cross-sectional area in respect to the height since it's changing with time. So if we look at our cone and we drew a triangle and we said that this top bar was h of t, then we know that this angle, theta, from the center of that triangle is related to this radius, which we'll call big R, as such. The radius of the changing cross-sectional area is equal to h times tan of that angle. So plugging this into our equation up here, so you can see this first term is the velocity at point 1. We have the cross-sectional area at point 1. We have the velocity at point 2, which is the differential, and the changing cross-sectional area at point 2. So we could rewrite this so that we have h on one side and everything else on the other side. At this point, we would separate out the variables and integrate this function. And since we're interested in how long it takes to drain such a tank, we're going to go from a time of 0 to a time of t. And this is going to be at an initial level, so at this point, h, we'll call initial, to h final, which could be 0 if we were just in completely draining it, or if we chose a height, then we could determine the time to get to that height. This gives us the following upon integration. And lastly, we're interested in the time, so if we take everything on the left side except for time, we're left with the following. So we see t is going to be a function of the radius at the bottom of the cone, as well as the angle of the cone, and our initial and final height that we're interested in. So it's important to note, based on the assumptions we made prior, this equation relating time to the height of the fluid is independent of what the density of that fluid is. So let's apply this to, say, a street cone. So here we have our street cone, and we'll make up some numbers. Probably, let's say if we fill this up with a fluid, we have a height of about 1 meter and a radius, let's say an opening here, a diameter of 3 centimeters. And this angle, again, that angle is important. We'll say that this angle theta is 15 degrees. So using this information, we're curious just to know how long it would take that fluid to drain from that cone. So let's start plugging in some numbers into our equation. So plugging in all the correct numbers, make sure your units are right. I get a time of approximately 29 seconds to drain a street cone that has 1 meter of fluid using these properties on the side. So let's remember we have to use a simplified Bernoulli equation here. We assume that the pressure at point 2 and point 1 was equal to atmospheric pressure, so we cancel those out. We also assume that the change in water height up here, velocity at point 2, was much less than that at the bottom. But as the height reaches the bottom, we can see that this isn't going to hold true. It does offer a pretty simple approximation for this case, though. So remember, we got velocity at point 1 using a simplified Bernoulli equation and the continuity equation to relate it to the velocity at point 2. Now, this allows us to develop a relationship between the time and height of the fluid in the conical tank. Now, an interesting follow-up to this work would be to see at what ratio big R of the conical tank to little r this equation would hold, and in what range of theta. You can imagine as theta becomes 0, the velocity at point 1 is just going to approach the velocity at point 2, and we would have something that looked like pipe flow. In this case, we would have to find a new relationship using the Bernoulli equation.